Me, 48 male, and parents 80 male plus 78 female, my parents made the first polite request for reconciliation after too much stuff happened, including them declaring me legally dead. I am not used to them accepting my choices or showing respect, and unsure how to deal with them or if I should talk to them at all. This story started in Germany almost 30 years ago. I had just turned 16 when I was accused of stealing a neighbor's automobile and smashing another neighbor's fence with it while from the cops. When the cops came to fetch me up, I was inebriated. This is permitted in Germany. I declared my innocence, but no one believed me. Because I was unrepentant, I was convicted and sentenced to 500 hours of community service. My parents used it as a tactic to take away my time with my friends. They convinced the court that I had to work at the THW on Friday and Saturday nights, an organization that will provide disaster relief and sometimes soup kitchens. In addition, I lost my moped license and was unable to get a driver's license until I was 20. In addition, if I ever wanted to acquire my license, I'd have to pass a psychiatric exam. In addition, the money I had saved for a vehicle, about 10,000 DM, was utilized to cover the damages. Unfortunately, it worked. My buddies quickly lost interest in me, since I was unable to party on weekends. We were also quite car-oriented, and I was doomed to be a pedestrian for the next 4 years. My uncle led the local THW and conveniently lost my timesheets for work done at the THW, forcing me to labor there for 14 months, clocking in at little more than 900 hours. The time I spent there taught me a lot, and it was an intriguing job that I would have preferred if I hadn't been compelled to do it. My parents said that they were acting in my best interest by keeping me away from my friends, and that they had begged my uncle to keep me there longer, so that I would be forced to learn to accept responsibility for my behavior. That period came to an end, as all things do. I left unapologetic and enraged at them for effectively tripling my sentence. I was in terrific condition and performed well in school since I had lost my friends and had no desire to make new ones after witnessing how fickle they were. Academics were an outlet that was not imposed on me by others, and I appreciated it. Then I discovered who had caused the vehicle accident. I informed the police, my parents, and attempted to get my sentence overturned. I attempted a Wiederauf Namverfahren, but was unsuccessful since my sentence had already been served. The real perpetrator was sentenced to merely 100 hours of community service. During his trial, it was revealed that other individuals had suspected him. Not to mention my parents, who forced him to pay for the damages about a year ago. They had placed the funds in a bank account, which they promised I would get after I completed my schooling, school and university or apprenticeship. They also deposited 15,000 DM into my savings account for the hours I worked with the THW, which was a great pay for a teen. Still, I was enraged because I would have to wait until I was 20 to receive a driver's license. If they had notified me sooner, I could have had the sentence overturned. Also, they may pay me $25,000 in roughly 5 years, but for the time being, they have practically stolen my funds, and they weren't giving it back because they believed I was too young to make my own decisions. After a fierce battle, I grabbed my tent and tented in the woods. I'm still going to school, but I'm not returning home. After a week, they phoned the police, who confiscated my tent and ordered me to return home. I was 17 years old. When the cops went, so could I every day, I went to school. I slept wherever I could find a place to sleep. As I no longer had a tent, I stayed mostly in barns and in the woods if the weather permitted. On occasion, the cops tracked me down. My parents phoned them every day for assistance. If I was caught, I would be compelled to return home. They confined me in a room, but I just waited for school to end and then left. I finally turned 18 years old. The cops could no longer compel me to return home. I just had a half year left in school, so I proceeded in this manner. I had no friends because I smelled awful, and I had no desire to make any friends since I had been injured and was not willing to allow anybody close to me harm me again. Despite this, I was able to graduate from high school with honors. After school, I took advantage of the necessary military duty to vanish. I volunteered for overseas duty, which at the time meant Eastern Europe. I was finished after 2 years and had a big nest egg. I had no close friends throughout my time in the military, but at least I wasn't a pariah. I went to university and majored in chemistry. I made 3 excellent friends and met my first girlfriend, who I am now married to. My parents tracked me down when I was 29 and working on my doctorate. They sometimes persuaded the police to hunt for me as a missing person. When the cops discovered me, I told them I was all right, but didn't want to talk to my parents again, and that was the end of it. The police assured them that I was okay, that they couldn't find me, and that they should stop using the police. Then my parents had a brainwave. They said that I perished in an accident in Italy. Because they were my next of kin, the cops provided them my address. Meanwhile, my bank account was blocked. The university informed me that I was no longer permitted to work on my PhD while dead, and many other things stopped functioning for me. My parents appear in front of my apartment 2 days into this calamity and want to speak with me, telling me that I compelled them to perform this action. They push their way inside and tell me they'll remain until I'm ready to speak to them and repair fences. I told them they could take the apartment if they insisted, and I grabbed my laptop, a few keepsakes, vital papers, and a suitcase full of clothing. I went away, leaving the keys behind. It took me a few months to persuade the bureaucracy that the stories about my death were much overblown. My landlord was incredibly sympathetic and offered me everything remained in my apartment once my parents realized I wouldn't be returning. They largely took the photographs I had left in the apartment. They left me a note, which I destroyed. I was furious because being dead had caused me so many problems. I was scared they would find me again. So as soon as I earned my PhD, I accepted a position in another city. That happened 15 years ago. They tracked me down once more. They sent a relative this time, who apologized and said they didn't want to burst when they discovered me, and they didn't want to force me to vacate my apartment at the time, but their emotions got the best of them. They would respect it if I continued to want no contact, but they would welcome me and my wife to dinner. To be honest, I'm at a loss on what to do. What am I supposed to do? Some unrelated information that did not fit in. I was never able to get a driver's license. I failed the psychiatric exam because I refused to face my drinking issue. I would have had to demonstrate contrition for a drunk driving event that I did not commit, so I gave up on that. I could probably obtain it today without taking the exam, but I'm accustomed to not having a driver's license and don't need one. I never received the money from my parents, and I don't need it. They are most likely still holding it with interest in the account. They are self-righteous jerks, but they tried all they could to steer me in the right direction. I'm certain that if I had called them and said, "I'm through with study and have a job, please send the money to that account," they would have done it. At the time, having no communication with them was more essential to me. Story 2. I cheated on my ex and it was the worst thing I ever did. Just told her over a year later, and I think I've made it worse. So for background, I was dating this lady who, by all accounts, was fantastic. She'd never done anything to harm me. She was nice and kind and hilarious as hell. We dated for a few months before the first COVID lockdowns occurred, leaving us separated in various places. We kept saying, "Oh, it's just a 2-week lockdown," and, "Oh, they're only putting a few weeks on," but we ended up staying for 6 months, which was longer than we'd been dating, and I ended up sleeping with a common acquaintance. I felt dreadful. I wanted to tell her, but then we broke up, so I decided to keep it to myself in order to preserve the memories of our connection. In reality, I was simply being a coward. In the year that followed, I continued to have casual with the common buddy, but we kept it a secret since we didn't want questions asked. I've also been chatting to my ex on and off, and if I'm fully honest, I've had emotions for her the whole time, way to express it I know, and she's brought up the thought of us a few times, but I've always shot it down because I felt bad and that it would be unjust to her. Fast forward to last week when my ex invites me to a party with a common friend with whom I cheated. I attended, but the mutual friend did not show up. At the party, I confessed to my ex that I had cheated, and she was understandably upset. She asked if it was a random or someone I knew, and I said it was someone I already knew. She didn't ask any more questions, but she seemed to want to patch things up and still be friends, which I would have appreciated. Then she called me last night, unhappy, feeling betrayed, and saying she knew who I'd cheated on her with and that someone else had informed her. I doubt she'll ever speak to me again. All I want to do right now is apologize again and again, but I'm going to comply with her request not to contact her. I wish there was something I could do to improve things. I detest myself for hurting her so horribly, and I'd give everything and have a chance to make up to her. But I'm at a loss on what to do.